Hello YouTube, this is Mary once again. Today I want to introduce to you Harold E. Toliver. He's my good friend and he's written a book titled Powerful Quotes. And today I want to give him an opportunity to tell us more about his book. I just want to ask him a few questions about the book. And maybe a few about himself, if he wants to divulge that information. Harold.
Yes.
How old are you?
I am 66.
66.
I'll be 67 December the 4th.
Oh, man, you look good. You look good for that age, man.
Yeah, I take care of myself also.
Well, I am 66. Okay. But anyway. Much ado about nothing. Harold, tell me and my audience how your spiritual journey began.
My spiritual journey started when I went to St. Peter's Catholic Church and started in the kindergarten.
Oh, kindergarten.
Yeah, and that was the first thing they taught us about God and Jesus. And, you know, asking us who is God and where is God. You know, God is everywhere.
So this is, you are kindergarten age.
Kindergarten.
Five years
my
old.
My first day is in school.
And this is a Catholic school.
Catholic school.
That's introducing you about God and not about ABCs or...
No, we had to study about God and Jesus.
Wow, so your spiritual journey began very early.
Yes, I knew that they taught us about God and Jesus. And there wasn't no workbook or anything.
Oh, really? It's just talking.
Yes, just talking.
So these were... And what do you call them? Nuns that would teach you.
Oh, yeah, yeah, nuns, preachers, not preachers, but they priests.
The nuns, yes. And the priests.
Also, I was an altar boy.
Oh, you were an altar boy, too?
Yes.
Oh, man.
I was an altar boy for about 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yeah.
Oh, man, this is interesting.
Yeah.
So, okay, here you are, this little boy, being introduced about Jesus and God.
Yes.
And that's when it kind of got in your heart or your mind to search for this God, or did you find God there?
Well, I became God conscious. Even though I didn't know I was God conscious,
mm-hmm.
because that was the only thing that was ringing in my head. You know, I know who God is. You know, when I told my mother.
Oh,
I know
did?
Who God is. I know about Jesus. And, you know, my mother said,
really?
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Oh, yes. Kind of like when the kids come home from school, they tell their mother what they learned.
Yeah.
So you were excited, little boy.
Yeah. And that been my hero, you know. You know. So that's how it got started, you know, me being God conscious and looking at reality, the world, people, you know. Different personality, and I'm wondering, do everybody know God? You know, they probably have to come to St. Peter's to know God like us.
Oh, okay. That's kind of like you were just endorsing St. Peter's because this is where God is.
Yeah, that's where I got my lessons from St. Peter's,
Peter's.
Learning about God.
Okay, so that's a very early journey.
And I wanted to be just like God.
Oh, you wanted to be just like
God.
Yes,
in my book, about me, let me see.
You want to read a little bit about yourself in the book? You see, you dedicate a page to your mother.
Yeah.
Oh, I see that. About you.
Yeah, it's about me. And so this was what made me write this about me. Because, you know, when I went home and told my mother that I know who God is, you know, and I was proud of myself.
Oh, you know? Really?
And she told me, oh, that's good. That's nice, you know. So that was our first lesson. Who is God? And, you know, I like to read it, you know, to.
Oh, you want to read it? Okay, read it.
Where it said, I am, the I am, the I am created me to be. I am. All of us must return to the Christ consciousness. The rhythm of the truth of I am and self-love equals self-discipline. I am growing my way to God. I have a strong desire to better myself mentally and spiritually. I have a genuine desire to improve myself and to elevate myself spiritually. As I live my life and as I grew into manhood, I pray to the Creator of all life to help me love myself so I could love everybody in my lifetime on earth, like as in heaven. I pray for the understanding of love. I meditate upon it daily. When I am loving God, I am loving me simultaneously. I am you, God, and that I am is me. I do not compete. I cooperate through God's universal liberating laws. I have no religion. Only truth is my God. When one knows God, there is no need for religion, dogma, or formal statement of belief. I practice no ritual or ceremony. I do not believe in God. I know God. God, I love you. So I feel that.
That is nice.
So, and that's the beginning of this book.
That's the beginning powerful of quotes. The book's powerful quotes.
Yes.
Okay, now, these quotes in this book, mm-hmm. where did you get all of these quotes from?
Well, most of them come from out of the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
King James Bible.
The King James Bible.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And there was, when I first started studying the book, I study the book of Proverbs. I didn't care about the Old Testament or the New Testament. Well, it's in
the Old Testament.
Yeah, the Old Testament.
Proverbs. Yeah, Proverbs
in the Old Testament.
It's part of Old Testament.
And I like those sayings, you know, in the Bible, you know, how to be wise, you know, words of wisdom, mm-hmm. and that's what I wanted, just like I wanted God, you know, to be in my life, you know, I want that, so that's why I say I am you, God, and you are me, and you know, and I feel that way, that's, you know, that gave me a feeling that I'm God too, you know. But I didn't know nothing, but that's what I felt.
So when you read Proverbs, that little boy that met God at St. Peter's, you associated Proverbs with that same feeling.
That's where I'm going to find God. That's only, you know, that's where I'm going. Because I can hear, you know, God talking to me by reading,
Proverbs. Okay, Proverbs.
And I was thinking that Proverbs gonna let me know everything about the New Testament.
Yeah,
and the
where
Old
you
Testament.
Left off.
Yeah.
So it kind of rekindled that relationship.
Yeah.
When you was in there. So how long did you stay at St. Peter's?
I went to St. Peter's all the way to the fifth grade. My daddy lost his job, and he couldn't pay the tuition anymore.
Mm,
so I had to go to a public school.
Oh, okay. That happened.
Yeah. So that's when I became a bad boy.
You became a bad boy after you left Catholic school. But you still had God somewhere in your heart.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and when I first started reading the Bible, now I read the 23rd Psalm.
Okay. You know, that's
and that the, my favorite verse in the 23rd Psalm when it says, I fear no evil. And that's
and thou
what
art
I,
with me.
That's
yeah.
what I love. Mm-hmm. You know, I fear no evil. So that what made me, hey, I didn't fear nobody.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. like some people say, don't be scared. Mm-hmm. I'm never scared. So that's me.
So take away all the fear, and that's what you were about. No fear.
No fear. And nobody, you know, devil or nothing, you know. Devil didn't have nothing on me.
So, okay, now, tell us about, okay, so you took this book from quotes, some from the Bible,
yeah.
and then from other books. So when did you get these books? Where did you, went to the library or what? Where did you get all these books?
I got all my books from the bookstore.
Bookstore.
That's where I got most of my books. And most of my books that I was reading, metaphysical books.
Oh, so you're an avid reader. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, let me backtrack.
Okay.
Now, when I was about to, this year was back in 74, 75.
1975, okay.
Yes, and I was in my apartment, and there was a box of books came to my mailbox, my address, my name, and I wasn't a reader.
Really?
No. And it was several books. It came to there about four different times. It was in a box. It could become four books at a time.
Okay? Mm-hmm.
And so in all the books that I read was one book. I'm gonna forget.
You read one book out of all of these books that they sent you?
Yes, and I wasn't a reader.
Oh, okay.
You know, like they said, you know, black people don't read.
So, you know? So these books came to you by mistake.
I don't know if it was by mistake.
I mean, the universe don't make mistakes.
Somebody knew my name, and I wasn't a type of person that read books, but one book caught my attention.
Okay.
And it taught me about how to use your mind.
Your mind.
How to help, you know, how to get riches, and how to carry myself, the words I should speak, you know.
So that's the first book that you read. Now, let me ask you this. These books that came to your apartment, were they addressed in your name? Or
yes.
Really?
Yeah, like I said, they're addressed in my name. I was in my apartment. That was my first apartment.
And these books, somebody sent you these books?
Somebody I don't know when.
Oh, man.
I don't know who, why me? You know, all these books. Because I was thinking about throwing them all in the trash.
Oh, man.
But I took them up to my apartment and started opening up all the boxes and books and thumbing through them. And one caught my eye.
That's kind of like divine intervention. Yeah.
And that one book got me started reading
that
books.
One book.
And
you told me earlier, let me see, in the back of this book, It seems like it's about almost 50 references of books that you used to
all my books,
your quotes.
All my books come from Half Price Bookstore.
Half Price. You save
that
money like
that.
That
was my hand. Yeah. And so that's why those books inspired me to. Those good books. I used to just live in Half Price Bookstore.
Oh,
every
yeah.
weekend, I go there.
I used to hang out there a lot when I was younger, too. I love it. Man.
And every time I go, there's a book that they're waiting on me.
A new book.
It's not, you know, they don't
I mean, yeah, new books, a book that you don't have.
Yeah. So, you know, I go to a Half Price Bookstore and buy about three or four books,
mm-hmm.
you know, because and when I look at them, I say, oh, man, I want to know these things.
Yeah.
You know, and I know it would get me closer to God.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why I say in my book, I don't have no religion, you know, that this I search on my own.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted everything, what I know, come from God.
Come from God.
So, and, you know, school just wasting my time. because I got to stay busy with my father.
So are you affiliated with a religion or a church? Or go to church or what?
Yeah, when we went to public school, there was a local church there in the projects area. Mm-hmm. And Monga Avenue Baptist Church.
Monga Avenue.
And man, that church scared the bejesus out of
me. Oh, it scared you? Why?
Because they be hollering when the preachers get to preaching and hollering, women, you know, dress flying, and they all on the floor, and the, you know, nurses.
They're rolling and
to
stuff.
Put the sheet over the woman's leg, and they hollering and screaming. And then that's when I said, that's hell.
so
Lord.
So if that's the way you got to meet God, you just didn't want to
Well,
do it
I didn't want it that way because I know it didn't go that way. Oh, you know, God is about peace. Ain't about no hollering.
Yeah, nah, man. That is amazing.
Yes.
But this is a wonderful book, you guys, and let me see.
Well, you know, like it's just that all these quotes inspired me. Every word in this, see, this I call this is my Bible.
This is your Bible.
This is my Bible. You know,
can I see
my Bible?
Book up
is, and it's, that's why. Well, Mary, you had a help in naming.
Yeah, I mean,
to give you that.
Well, and Harold, he. I don't want to take over your...
Go ahead. You've been a big help. I mean, you've been a big help.
Well,
I don't think I can... I wouldn't have been able to write this book.
But Harold, originally, you kept all of these quotes written down in red ink in a notebook.
Right.
Writing all six notebooks with an ink pen.
Right. And there was a reason for me to write all of this, you know, my journal down with red ink.
What was that reading?
Because Jesus' words was in red ink.
Oh, in the Bible. Bible.
Yeah.
That's why you did
that.
I get it now. Because I remember
that's why I said, this is my Bible.
I remember asking you, I said, how many red pens did you use going through this? Because this man had over six full notebooks.
Yes.
With all of these quotes. And I would read them. He would bring them to me and I'd read them. I said, oh, they're so inspiring.
Mm-hmm.
But they wasn't in order. They're just quotes. You know, he would get these ideas and he would write them down. But so I said, do you want to make this into a book?
Mm-hmm.
And you said, can it be a book?
Yeah.
I said, it's already a book, but I can help you organize it.
And you did.
And man, we ended up grouping all of these quotes into different subjects, and we came up with the table of content.
Yeah.
And let me see if I could show you, say, different chapters. We have a chapter one, the concept of God.
Yeah, that's the first chapter.
The first chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Chapter two, universal laws and freedom. And your favorite, chapter three, who is Jesus? And this is very thorough. And it goes on, but it goes to chapter 12. But tell me, what is your most favorite quote in this book? I know all of them are just favorites, but which one do you just like the most?
I wish I had my old book, because I have it that I like.
Oh, you had it written?
Okay. Well, you know all of them.
All of them is hard to decide.
I'm trying to find a favorite. I know there is a favorite.
Let me
see
which one is mine. I mean, that's the concept of God.
Because everything that I write, I feel it.
I tell you what I like the most.
Okay.
This one. About truth and lies. The realize. And that, you remember,
that's what opened up your eyes.
Yeah, that's when I typed it for him and I saw that, I said, where did you get that from? And he made it into a t-shirt. But I asked him, where'd you come up with that? Because you were really saying realize three times.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, Mary said, differently. And,
yeah.
And I said, realize, real lives. It's like, oh man, so that's so really catchy.
It's real too.
It is. Yeah, it is. That's the important. It's real.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
And we
I'm all about the real.
Yeah, you know, we want truth. Things that's real today.
Yeah.
This is amazing. Mm-hmm. This book is, I can't say enough.
I was guided by a spirit. Okay, and I didn't have no patience to do this on my own. It had to be a spirit to make me concentrate. And I mean, when on the job, I take all my notes with me.
Yeah.
And when we have some downtime, man, I'd be in there on the desk, and I just start writing.
And he would write with this red pen, and I can't hold a pen that long. My knuckle will hurt. But he would write with a red pen, and mind you me, I did not find any mistakes. So how can you had to be guided to write all of the six notebooks without any mistake.
I was so inspired with these quotes that I just had to see it complete.
It was the Holy Ghost on you, in your hands, not make mistakes.
I feel like I'm a creator too, like my father.
Oh, so you created that. You had to be a creator to do that.
Yes. I had the patience and everything.
To handwrite this with an ink pen, a red ink pen.
And I write real slow.
You had to write real slow, not to make a mistake.
Yeah, I just wanted that. I had to put these words on paper, you know, and they are my words.
They're your words.
You know, you know, and like the Bible, it has it words.
Mm-hmm.
So I had the patience and just inspired just to put it in a book.
The words that you chose out of all these books, it said, okay, one quote said, words lie, but deeds do not.
Amen.
True resurrection is the awakening of the inner conscience. So this, I mean, it's not like you're going to get thee and thou and all Bible quotes. This is amazing.
It felt you know, there's a term in the Bible that says we are creators also.
Yeah, so.
So this is my creation.
This is your creation.
Mm-hmm. So that made me feel like
we are.
There's God in each and every
one
of us.
That's right.
Just like each and every one of us, we all have an angel.
Yes, we do. We do.
All our life.
That's right.
Yeah.
So. Oh, man. And when I go through it and I just say, oh, man, after, here's one that said, no religion is greater than truth. Men should love the truth. When a glimpse of truth is seen, people disregard it because they are attuned to only their limited five senses.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll get a variety of different quotes about love and faith and fear. It's a whole chapter on fear in this book. So I want you guys to order Harold's book, Powerful Quotes, from Amazon.com, Harold E. Toliver.
That's
him. And the book is $19 and some change, shipping and handling, whatever. But this is a wonderful book. And
inspirational.
Very inspirational. And I'm so glad that he decided to come and talk about his book, Powerful Quotes. Another look at it, and look at the cover. It's beautiful.
Yeah. Well, you know, I wanted everybody that, you know, buy my book. Now, people might not like this. What I'm about to say is that you don't have to go to church to know God.
Yeah, that's true.
You don't need no all that shouting and soft words and the music arguing and you don't need that. You need to bring out of you, bring God out of you.
Bring God
and put God in front of you.
That's it.
And all you're doing. Love God with all your heart, mind, and soul. And that's what I went with. That's why this book is here.
So, basically, to do all this, you still have to know God. That's the beginning, to know God.
That's the main thing.
And to know God, you have to know yourself.
Yes. Where is that where it said, I don't believe God?
I know God.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a tricky.
I think it's in the front. When you say I don't believe in God.
Yeah, I don't believe God. I say I don't believe God. Mm-hmm. And then I pause and I say I know God.
I know God.
You know, so it's just like my daddy. You know, I wanted to be like my dad. You know, my physical dad. Mm-hmm. And so I figured that I can do the same thing with God. You know, my God, you know, brought me here, and God brought me here, so I choose God over my
dad. Over your father, that's, okay.
Mm-hmm. So that's my whole outlook about my life, God, love, and beauty. It's just good to be alive.
Well said. Mm-hmm. Okay, guys, we're coming up on 26 minutes. Thank you for listening to the words from Powerful Quote and Harold E. Toliver. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.
Yeah, if you buy the book, give me the feedback.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Do that on Amazon. Give us some feedback on Amazon.
Yeah, I would love to know because... I wish everyone can know God just like I know God.
Mm-hmm. That's all. It's a good friend, huh?
Yeah.
I mean.
No religion.
No religion, yeah. But a good friend. Man, yeah. Your best friend.
Yes, the creator.
Yeah. Okay, Harold will be back on the show again because he has a lot of things to tell, to enlighten us. So he'll be back again at his own convenience, okay?
Thank you, Mary.
Oh, you're welcome. Yeah. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.